Welcome to this video tutorial on how to do a multi-bitrate stream with Flash Media Live Encoder. To start, we're going to start in our panel. Simply go to your panel and either select a pre-made live player or create a new one from the panel itself. So for my purposes, I'm going to reuse a player that I already have. Got this one here. And to start, I'm going to click on the Broadcast Now button, which opens the broadcast panel. In the broadcast panel, I'm going to select as my source Adobe Flash Media Live Encoder and copy the RTMP URL. Once we've copied the RTMP URL, we're going to open Adobe Flash Media Live Encoder. In Adobe Flash Media Live Encoder, we have to set up a few things. First, we're going to choose our video source, so I've already selected my camera. Format we're going to set to H.264, as that's the main one that we need to use for streaming. Frame rate, I'm going to up it to 25 frames per second, but usually around 25 to 30 frames per second is the right one. Input size, I've chosen my input size as 720p. And bitrate is set to single bitrate at the moment at 500 by a small size. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to up the size here to 720p. And I'm going to add up to kilobits to 1.2, but you can choose anything you like yourself. So that's for single bitrate streaming. Let's continue with the audio. I'm going to choose my microphone. Format has to be changed to AAC to be mobile compatible. Same as with the H.264. So we want H.264 with AAC to be fully mobile compatible here. Channel, you can choose mono or stereo. I'm going to leave mine as mono. I'm going to set the sample rate. Has to be a minimum of 44/100. Because we need to ensure that the full multi-bitrate streaming and mobile compatibility is there, which only starts at 44,100. Otherwise, you will start having jitters, etc. So make sure this is 44,100. So let's go over the main points. We want H.264, AAC, and 44,100 as a sample rate. So I'm happy with the rest of the settings. Now we're going to do the stream part. So we just copied from our broadcast panel the RTMP URL, which we're going to type here in the FMS URL in Flash Media Live Encoder. So we pasted it in, and now we need the stream key. Now the stream key I'm going to simply copy from our broadcast panel. And once copied, I'm going to put it into the stream part. So now we're ready to do a single bitrate stream here. So if I start up my stream now, we're going to start a single bitrate stream, and it should come over in a few seconds. We can see it's connected, it's encoding correctly, and if we look over here, it's working perfectly. So that's working fine, but we don't want to do single bitrate streaming. We want to do multi-bitrate streaming, so we're going to stop the stream. And now to enable multi-bitrate streaming, we have to add at the end of the stream key, and this is very important, so you add a percentage sign and a I. So percentage sign I will engage the server to multi-bitrate streaming when we start our stream. So adding this percentage and I on the stream key allows us to now come over here and enable multiple bitrates. So we're going to enable another bitrate at a lower resolution. What can I do? I'll do 380 and add, say, for example, 500 kilobits. I'm going to enable a third one as well at 260, for example, for mobile devices. And that's going to be at, yeah, let's leave it at 200 kilobits per second. So essentially, the way that multi-bitrate streaming works is you're going to be sending three simultaneous streams at the same time to the servers. The servers will automatically find out which device your user is using and also what quality of speed they have to watch the video. So depending on the speed that they have, it will switch automatically for the user to the right quality from the three bitrates that you're sending. So say, for example, one of your users starts off with a very low bandwidth. He only has like 300 kilobits to download. He's going to start with this one here, watching that stream. And then whilst he's watching, for some reason, he just starts getting more bandwidth. So maybe more bandwidth from the connection that he's using is freeing up. So he's going to start jumping up to the highest quality that he can. So it changes dynamically up and down depending on your viewer's quality that they have available for their broadband speed. So over here, we also see a total of the bitrates readout. So we can see the first video and audio bitrate together is 1.248 kilobits. The second one is 548, and the third one is 248. A total of just over 2 megabits is required upload to maintain that quality of all three streams. So please ensure that this total number, that you do have it available, and usually I say add an extra 10% of availability on top of that at least, to make sure that your live stream is nice and smooth. So we're going to start the live stream now. And in the readout, we can see it's going to start connecting all three streams, which are working perfectly fine now. If we come back to our live player and we refresh it quickly to get the multi-bitrate streaming from it, we can see that the multi-bitrate stream is arriving at our local preview player. So that's perfect. It's arriving now. I want to pass it on to the live player, to my viewers. So I'm going to click Start Broadcast, and it's going to start passing it on to the live viewers now. So we're doing full multi-bitrate streaming. To show you that it's full multi-bitrate streaming, we have a HD button over here. If you click it, you can see all three streams coming through. So that shows us that a multi-bitrate streaming is working. Setting is selected as auto at the moment, and you can also manually change between them if you need to. Same for your viewers as well. So yeah, that's essentially how simple it is to do multi-bitrate streaming. Thank you for watching, and we'll see you again.